Slippy back in here with apparently the agility of a spider monkey. It's a testimonial from real Smash players in this region. What round is this, my friend?
This is finals.
We got that winner's finals rocking and rolling. Alright, we are starting off Corrin versus Mario Battlefield. The games begin, as they say. Nice nares from Lyrex. Zapdos trying to look to get in for a grab. Do the typical Mario. Ooh! Here I was thinking that he was going to do the up tilt combo, but instead he just forward throws and then spikes. Not high enough percentage to kill right now, as it is just the start of the game, but it will definitely put the fear of gravity in Lyrex at this moment. Lyrex landing hard on that top platform. Lyrex just dodging Zapdos' grab right there. Zapdos trading and then taking a stun. Oof. And approaching with back air to claim the first knock off of Zapdos. Lyrex was in that ledge trap for the long game. Nice work by Zapdos, up smashing as Lyrex gets back to the stage. Zapdos now has his flood charge, and up smash will almost kill Lyrex, but we don't die, we DI. Oh man, I stole that from Kid Goggles. At least I think it was him. Woo-hoo! 160% on Lyrex, and Zapdos will go low for the back air, claiming the first stock. Stocks are now 1-1. Ooh! Lyrex going a little bit too far to the right, and just landing himself in a forward air from Zapdos. Another early spike, not enough to kill yet again, but it's... hopefully, Zapdos is hoping it's a premonition for the future. Lyrex climbing in percentage. Ooh. Almost getting caught on the roll into the stage. Lyrex looking to bring this percent difference back. Nice stun and a nice response. Double poking shield. Lyrex was caught in the end lag after trying to use his neutral B to set out his fireballs. And it seems like Lyrex is actually doing a really good job of taking command of this game once again. Ooh, up throw, not enough damage just yet. Ooh, side me on the ledge. The winner is Corrin. Piercing the stage and piercing Mario. Survival. Needle arm right through the hat. I hope Mario did not plan on getting his deposit back. All right, we're gonna run back for game two. Lyric's starting off by trying to get in there with forward airs on the platform. A little more aggressive start than last. And Zapdos is taking a little bit of an advantage, putting him up to 35%. Pretty neutral game at this point. I mean, there is a percent difference. Zapdos winning out by about 40%. Oh, there we go. Lyrex once again, neutral being on shield, and Zapdos able to capitalize with a throw. And it happens a third time. And it continues to a spike, taking off the first stock from Lyrex. Really good work by Zapdos. Turning the ledge guard around by shielding and then grabbing after F smash. Zapdos taken Lyrex for a ride, even percents, but there's a stock difference. Lyrex needs to put in a lot of work to bring the stock difference to even. Oof. Ooh, nice back air. Good work from Zapdos. Zapdos back airing Lyrex onto a platform and then back airing him off. Up throw will not kill just yet. Even though there's rage, even though there's high percentages, and up air will claim the first stock off of Zapdos. About halfway into the full time, and we have a max rage coin, but a 0% Zapdos. Lyrex is going to have to try really hard. All it takes is a back air, and Mario has this game on lockdown. Oof. Smart move by Lyrex. Knowing that Zapdos is going to go low, looking to throw like a nair or a back air. Oh! And speaking of back air, Zapdos takes game two by just dropping off of the platform and giving him a boot. We're gonna go into game three. We did see a switch from Lyrex going from Korin to Lucina, still staying in the realm of Fire Emblem. Zapdos will remain Mario. Zapdos seems to be a bit more aggressive in this matchup than he was. That's a pro down there. Lyrex doing some decent damage with Lucina's aerials, closing the percent gap. Ooh. Lyrex getting sent upward by the flood, but luckily Platfriend is here to keep you safe. And Lyrax has officially put more percent onto Zapdos than he has taken. Ooh. But we're going to see a greedy down throw into a spike at the right side of the edge stage. Zapdos holding onto. Oof. Zapdos with the two stock. I don't know about you guys at home, but this melee music makes me really want to just get down and breakdance, you know? Don't laugh. Alright, we're going into game 4. Lyrax switching back to Corrin. I guess he feels more comfortable with that character in this matchup. And we are going to be on Town and City. Yeah, Lyrax is a bit... seems to be a bit more standoffish this time around. That seems to be the way he is playing Corrin, at least against Zapdos as Mario. I'm assuming he was a tad more aggressive and Zapdos was able to punish with it. Oof! And another early spike, but this time it meets its mark. 36% was just enough. And a low enough point in the stage, Lyrax lost his first stock. Ooh, Lyrax with a series of nairs and then to the stun, but the mouth will not chomp chomp. The cartwheel up to the top of the stage, but there will not be. Ooh.
No contest.
3-1 for Zapdos. We're gonna see a quit out, no contest the last game. This winner's finals will remain unresolved, I guess. Could he have DI'd? Could he have not DI'd? We'll never know. Dude, do push-ups. It helps.
Oh wait, one. Okay.
So we are going to see Minus jump back into the game as we head into Losers Finals.